My mum's the funniest, kindest, just really lovely all-round woman. She just has really low days and panics a lot about things, and that doesn't make her any different to anybody else, really.
She means the world to me, and I look up to her because she is just the most amazing person that I've ever known. People look up to stars and like celebrities because of what they've achieved, but I actually look up to her because of what she's done for us. And she is such a strong person, and that's what keeps me going. So I just love her so much.
Christmas, a time of excitement for children, but for many who care for a parent or parents with mental health issues, this responsibility takes priority over the festivities going on all around. Two girls, both young carers, caring for mums who suffer with anxiety and depression. Carina is 20 years old. She's been caring for her mum since she was 5. Naz is 16 and has also been caring for her mum for many years. Two girls in Bristol who bravely carry the burden of adult responsibilities in their young lives.
She's just a normal mum, like everyone else. Like you, everybody's got parents, and she's my parent, and I don't see her like anything else. She's not mad, as people would say. And she's happy. That's all that matters. Oh, my mum suffers from depression, anxiety, and it was very hard for her to concentrate on certain things, especially in the kitchen. And like, she was able to concentrate, and she's cut her hands before using knives and burnt things and melted plastic and everything in the kitchen. So it came down to me to make sure that she was safe, and like my siblings were safe as well, and they did get something to eat. So yes, it's very hard, and it still is hard because she still suffers from it now, and it's better than before since I've started getting support, and that support means so much to me, and it means a lot to my mum as well, because I can see it in her as well. She's happier, she is actually more happy and confident than before she was. She had really low self-esteem as well, so now she's much better.
I think I started caring at 5, when my little sister was born. I'm not really sure whether that's when I first started to notice things, or whether that sort of the birth of my sister triggered something for my mum, but that's when my mum fell ill, and I started picking up things. So if mum was having sort of a difficult day, then I would do the washing up for her, or do the clothes washing for her, or it could be different things like taking my little sister out in the pram just to give my mum a little bit of space. And then also just listening to my mum as she was feeling stressed out. And then, yeah, right up to now, being 20, still caring for my mum.
This responsibility of caring for a parent can be identified when an intervention takes place to help one or both adults. Carina's support came after her little sister was born and her mum began to struggle. But Naz's needs were identified after her family were subjected to something altogether different. They were being racially abused.
You feel rotten inside. You feel like you're not worth it. You're not worth about anything. And it made, there's been times that I feel like, oh, why am I not like other people that are white and they get along with everyone?
Not only are children having to cope with these kind of prejudices while caring for a family member, they also have to cope with the stigma surrounding mental health. Despite their young years, Carina and Naz are now fully informed about anxiety and depression. Simon Smith works for Mental Health Bristol, and he makes sure young carers get all the support they need.
What's vital is that we get to young carers as quickly as we possibly can, make sure that, first of all, that they kind of are given information and support around kind of what they might be doing for their loved one, and then actually looking at kind of their own needs and actually kind of what support they might need to fulfill that caring role. There are lots of young children and younger adults out there who may not even be aware that they are in a caring role, and this is just their normal day-to-day life. And actually, one of the things that is imperative is that we make them aware that there is support available for them. Don't be frightened to look on the internet, find information, approach people. So if your mum or dad have a community psychiatric nurse supporting them, talk to them about what's going on, maybe a school tutor, maybe even pick up the phone and call some of the support agencies that are available, like the NSPCC, Bristol Care Support Centre, and the Bristol Black Carers Service. Support is available out there, information is out there for you. It's just a case of getting to it. For professionals, there needs to be a lot more done in the sense of identifying these young people and making sure that that information is given to them quicker. It's sometimes hard for a young person to firstly recognise they're in that role and secondly seek out that support. So as professionals, we need to be a lot better at getting that information to them.
That information from Mental Health Bristol, part of Avon and Wiltshire Mental Health Partnership NHS Trust, can steer children like Naz to find support with Young and Caring, part of the Bristol Black Carers charity. They support young carers who have specific needs due to their cultural backgrounds, and Naz's little brother and sister are benefiting too.
They love it. They're like, my sister's full of life now, and I can feel that my brother's so much happier. He's doing really well at school as well now, and like he's getting support, and knowing that there's someone, you know, that they're happy and I can ask someone if I need help or they want to get out a little bit, I can rely on them, and they can always have like a normal life now, and they can have a bit of a normal childhood, whereas I didn't really get that. I don't want them to suffer.
Carina was a young carer. She's now a young adult carer, and she started a young adult carer group here in Bristol.
I spoke with the Care Support Centre, and we came together and thought of a group called 18 Plus for 18 to 25 year old young adult carers. And we do things like we go for pub lunches, we go and watch shows, we go and just have a coffee, and it's just a chance to just have a chat, meet other young adult carers that have been able to go to university and still have their caring role, and speak to them about how they juggle that, how they work that out, so that it doesn't look, to me it wasn't possible, but now meeting people that have done it, it's made it look possible again. It's just fun. It's making sure that we're not losing those carers at that age, and they're not becoming hidden. And we meet once a month and just made some really great friends, really.
For Naz and Carina, this Christmas time will see them continue caring for their mums. They'll still be cooking and cleaning and looking after their brothers and sisters. There will be times when it all gets a bit stressful, but when those times happen, they know they have the support to cope. And if you're a young person watching this film right now and you think you might need support too, then just email Simon at simonsmith8@nhs.net or take a look at Mental Health Bristol Carers on Twitter. When the interviews were done, I asked Naz what she wanted for Christmas. She told me she didn't want anything. She just wants her mum, her little sister, and her little brother to be happy. So it looks like Christmas has come early for Naz.